One, two, three.
Do you think math is easy or hard?
Hard.
Is math hard for little kids or
hard?
Easy?
Easy. Easy.
It's easy? Why?
I don't know.
Let's play a game.
Each of them will have some dots.
Children are playing this computerized dot game in which they see two collections of dots.
Which one's more dots?
The dots are flashed too quickly to count, so they just have to use that intuitive gut number sense that we know we share with other animal species and that even newborn infants have.
Blue?
That's right.
And all kids have to do is tell us whether there are more blue dots or more yellow dots.
Awesome job! I think you know.
One, two, three, four.
After
five,
the dot
six,
game,
seven,
we gave children a portion of a standardized math assessment.
Which one's closer to three when you count?
Five. The children who in the dot game had the opportunity to sharpen their abilities by starting with the easier problems and gradually moving toward the hard problems did better at math.
20. So our research showed basically with a 5-minute simple computer game that has nothing to do with numbers, children actually could change their math performance from like a 60 percentile to like an 80 percentile.
Good job. What about 7?
By making kids better at doing these really simple dot judgments, we also made them better at school-based math, at least temporarily.
How did you know whether there was more blue or more yellow?
Because I'm intelligent.
These results are really exciting to us because they show a very clear connection between an evolutionarily ancient set of abilities and a uniquely human set of formal math abilities. That raises lots of interesting questions, including how long this kind of effect lasts and whether we can also improve children's math performance in a classroom setting.
That's right.